people's body size is deeply linked with race. I have a doctor. I don't need 6 billion doctors.
Weight discrimination. She says she did not get hired because of her size.
Those aren't real women. Real women are not that size.
The restaurant's response and why the law might not be on her side.
Now, that woman was hoping to get a job as a server at a League City pub. Hello, I'm Dominique Soxa.
I'm Bill Maessa. Thank you for joining us. Here's what's happened instead. When Sarah Brady showed up for that interview, she says she was turned away despite her qualifications.
Channel 2's Jennifer Bauer is at the Tilted Kilt Pub right off of the Gulf Freeway. She's joining us live now with Brady's complaint and the pub's response. Jen?
Well, this bar is not open yet. In fact, you can see on the sign it says coming soon. You can also see on the sign that the waitresses here wear very skimpy outfits, and that's exactly why a local woman says she wasn't hired.
Meet Sarah Brady. Sometimes I don't even know if these people are serious. There's plenty of other jobs she can do. She can be an office worker or even a truck driver. The possibilities are endless.
Sarah Brady was hoping to get hired as a waitress or even bartender at the new Tilted Kilt Pub opening soon in League City, but was shocked when she showed up for her interview and was turned away.
Thank you for coming and applying, but we've already filled all of the positions with more experienced candidates.
Sarah believes she was turned away because of her size.
I was really mad. I knew it probably had to do with I did not portray the brand image that they wanted.
A brand image that is advertised on their website. Kilt girls wear short skirts and small tops.
Real women are not that size.
In an email, a representative for Tilted Kilt told Channel 2, our hiring and employment practices are in full compliance with all laws. When hiring, we seek entertainer servers who not only fit the costume, but exemplify a personality and skill set that is friendly, courteous, and customer oriented.
There's no protection under the law for weight.
He says laws protect people who are discriminated against for race, sex, national origin, religion, and disability. But that's it.
Now, there's nothing for bald-headed people. There's nothing for short people. There's nothing for heavy people. There's just no protection under the law.
I hope that the next chubby girl, plus size, thick, whatever word you want to use to describe yourself, goes in and interviews with them. I hope you get the job.
Now, Sarah Brady tells us she has battled an eating disorder in the past, and now she says she is very proud of her body. We're live in League City. I'm Jennifer Bauer, KPRC, Channel 2 News.
Hello. How y'all doing?
Surviving.
Surviving, huh? So is that why you missed your last appointment?
Miss me with that bullshit. Bullshit.
You just had your bypass about 2 months ago, and when you left the hospital, you were down to 546, so you lost only 9 pounds since then. Renee has lost almost 50 pounds, and she hasn't even had her bypass yet. What in the world is going on with you?
I guess I'm eating wrong things.
You think it's funny? You have a gastric bypass.
I had a gastric bypass,
to
yes.
Lose weight. And you're not losing weight.
I don't eat a third what I
no,
ate
just
before I had
the
that
question.
Surgery.
Then
you're
we're not
asking
talking
me
about
questions
that
I don't understand no more than you understand.
What are you talking about? You're choosing to overeat and you think it's okay?
No, I don't think it's okay at all.
So what is going on?
I guess I'm not eating the right things. I mean,
we gave you the instruction that you need to follow, and you never followed. And now you're playing this kind of game, and you think that's okay? behind the work somebody.
I'm playing any game. I throw up constantly. I eat what I can keep down.
That's how it works. You throw up constantly because the surgery forces you to when you overeat.
My problem is I'm holding a lot of fluid. I can't hardly pee.
Really?
I mean, I don't know what. I mean, you.
What do you mean you don't know? And you think that you're not eating and you're getting.
I don't want to get malnourished either.
Do you look like you are malnourished?
Well, a woman says she felt fat shamed at Universal Orlando when she wasn't able to ride the King Kong attraction Skull Island.
She asked the crew if she could ride with one less person on the bench seat so she wouldn't make those sitting next to her feel uncomfortable. Channel 9's Lauren Seabrook sat down with her today. And Lauren, she says Universal staff refused that request.
And Greg, she says the whole thing was just humiliating. Universal doesn't have weight restrictions, so she didn't know she couldn't ride until she paid to get in and then was just about to get on.
This is actually my daughter's.
Angel Morales shares a love for Harry Potter with her daughters. They bought annual passes to Universal last year and couldn't wait to check out the Wizarding World. Angel spent a lot of money on souvenirs that first trip, but for her, the thrills fell short.
Couldn't fit on any of the Harry Potter rides because of my weight. Did a lot of bag holding in Diagon Alley and that kind of thing.
She hoped to ride Universal's King Kong attraction because the seat is a bench without a safety bar. But when they got to the front, she told her daughter she didn't think they would fit without making others uncomfortable. A man in line overheard the conversation and offered to wait for the next ride, allowing Angel to go with her daughters. So on their second trip back to the park, Angel tried to avoid more embarrassment by asking the Skull Island crew if one less person could ride in her row. She says they wouldn't allow it because they had to push for capacity.
It's somewhat humiliating to have to ask for an accommodation because of one's weight. You know, that you have to put yourself out there and kind of beg to be able to ride and embarrass yourself because of weight.
Angel filed a discrimination complaint with the Florida Commission on Human Relations and says she feels people who are overweight should be a protected class.
Their interest is getting bodies and getting money and not accommodating paying customers. That's how I felt.
And Angel says Universal did offer her a $100 gift card plus dinner and a movie, but she does not plan to return to the park.
In which she accepted. She received a $100 gift card, free food and movie tickets, according to sources. But of course, that wasn't enough, and she still filed a complaint.
Hi, I'm award-winning fat activist and professional feminist killjoy, Virgie Tovar.
Be an ally to women rather than an accomplice to patriarchy. Because, after all, patriarchy doesn't give a f*** about you, girl.
Stretch Mark distress call?
Yeah, my stretch mark lit up too. Chubby Dumpling? Where are you?
We should all go look for her.
Let's split up and cover more ground.
Yeah.
Chubby Dumpling, where are you?
We need some machetes.
How many machetes do you need?
Give us everything you've got.
Fuck you, vegetables!
You die, kale, die!
Die, veggie scum! You veggie sons of bitches killed my friends! Cheers! The veggies have been vanquished! We're back! Look at what we can do when we work together to vanquish patriarchy! I mean vegetables.
What's up, y'all? In the last post, we were talking about self-discipline. So I wanted to go into that a little farther. I believe that self-discipline is the definition of self-love. That when you say that you love yourself, that means that you have behavior towards yourself that is loving. It's like you say to yourself, hey, man, look, I know you want to eat that pizza and it'll be really good, you know, but I can't let you eat that, man. Because if you eat that pizza, you're going to feel like shit, you know. And I love you too much to let you eat that. And I think the word discipline has kind of gotten a bad name. We think about it in terms of punishment. I'm not talking about discipline in that way. I'm talking about discipline in the sense that you forego immediate pleasure for the exchange of long-term self-respect. Self-discipline is self-love. If you want to be happy, you have to love yourself, which means you have to discipline your behavior. The road to sustained happiness is through disciplining your behavior.
I'm liking this American boy, American boy. Take me on a trip, I'd like to go someday. Take me to New York, I'd love to see.